By the way, Kai, the sock on your mic really looks like a condom.
Yeah, man, I got it custom designed by Panda, man.
Actually, have you ever jacked off into a condom? A sock or a sock?
Nah, man, but I have once heated the peel of a banana and then jacked off into it, though.
Okay, that's our intro. Hello, guys. Welcome to the ITK podcast. My name is Dijaji Prime.
And this is Kai Ash.
And thank you for listening. I know that was a very weird intro, and we are quite weird people, and we hope you enjoy the show.
Shout out to that banana peel, though.
Yeah, shout out to that banana peel. I'm sure it was a very traumatic experience for that banana peel.
Yeah, man, we had such a connection, and 5 minutes later, I had to throw it into the dumpster.
Oh, gosh. I feel sorry for the banana peel's children.
Hey, dude, I'm pretty sure it had the time of its life, man.
Okay, then. Before we begin, we'd just like to say a few thank yous. Thank you to everybody who's listened to our podcast so far. We've had about 31 total plays on SoundCloud, which is pretty cool. Why are you laughing, man? Every journey begins with one step. Thank you to our good friend Yash for posting our podcast to her friends and shit. That we really appreciate that.
Yeah, we do.
And yeah, thank you to everyone who's so far followed. Thank you if you're listening on YouTube, SoundCloud, share with your friends and your family, and we hope you enjoy the show.
Yeah. And too bad we couldn't be on the podcast for last week's episode. Somebody had certain circumstances. So
by somebody, we mean you, you bitch-ass nigga. I thought it was homies over hoes, fam.
Hey, dude, you gotta do what you gotta do, man. When the
speaking
pussy
of
calm,
homies,
you gotta run.
Speaking of pussy, we're gonna be talking quite a bit about pussy today. So yeah. Please stick around. This bait, though, we're baiting the listeners in anyway. So,
well, it's all right, man. Not like we have any female listeners anymore after the last podcast.
We have one female listener.
She's here by force, man.
In retarded news, so you know who Troy Ave is?
I don't know, man. Is he a rapper?
Yes, he's a rapper. You know Joey Badass, right?
Yeah, I know.
So Troy Ave was like a New York rapper, and he was going at Joey Badass, I don't know what even happened because they're both independent rappers, and he was going at Joey Badass saying that he's the best independent rapper out of New York, and he was taking shots at one of Joey Badass's friends, and so yesterday he shot himself in the leg in some club. Like, how retarded do you have to be to, I think he killed someone. Or shot at someone and then shot him at himself and shot himself in the leg.
What the fuck? Wait, wasn't Troy Ave the one that was shot in T.I.'s party or some shit?
Yeah, he shot himself. He shot himself.
Oh my days, man. This guy's a fucking retard.
That's what happens when you make fun of dead people. Karma.
Well, so much for the gun laws in America, man. Even retards can get a hold of a gun, man.
So there have been a number of musical interviews this past couple of weeks. Both Kanye and Drake were on Ellen. Did you watch the interviews?
Nah, man. Couldn't be bothered, man. I don't like watching Ellen, man. She makes me feel weird and insecure.
What the fuck? How does she make you feel weird? Are you homophobic?
Nah, man. I think she has a bigger penis than me, man.
Okay, then, that bigger penis, though. But yeah, Drake and Kanye were on Ellen. Kanye was being Kanye as usual. I think Kanye is very, shy. He's a very shy person, and he needs to feel comfortable before he actually talks. Like, the first 5 minutes, he was pretty awkward, but I think Ellen understood that and made him, really comfortable. And then he just went on his rant about Michael Jackson and fashion and shit like that.
Dude, the way you talked about Kanye, now, you made him sound like that virgin girl, going up against a really experienced guy, and then he was talking down to her and shit like that, making her feel comfortable, man. You just made Kanye sound like such a bitch, man.
But isn't that all what you do when you have sex, though? You calm the girl and be like, okay, baby, I know it's big, but you're gonna have to take it, you know?
And then all of a sudden, 7.75 of an inch are in her first shove? That's when you know it's fucked up, man.
This specification on penis size, though. But we'll so yeah, Drake was on there, Kanye was on there, and they had some pretty interesting, you know, Drake got scared, even though I don't think he was really scared. I think he was just acting. And Wale, he has a new album coming out called Shine, and he was on both The Breakfast Club and Hot 97. But the reason I'm bringing up Wale is that he said something interesting on Hot 97. And you remember when we were talking a couple of weeks ago about One Dance, and I was like, Wizkid probably made that song and gave it to Drake.
Yeah.
Wale said something similar. He was like, it sounds like Wizkid's lyrics and it sounds like Wizkid's flow, and that Drake probably like was just highly inf he didn't really like he didn't come out straight and said like Wizkid gave him that song, but from what he was saying, he was like, you can hear his influence on like Controller and One Dance, and he wished that Wizkid had a bigger role on One Dance.
Yeah, definitely.
This definitely though. So let's while we're on music, what was your like early musical influences? What were you listening to early on?
To be honest, I don't know how I got into this hip hop game, and I think I was just like listening to Eminem and slowly grew into it and started listening to, I don't know, man. Like I had
Not
one,
just hip hop, like even if
yeah.
it's some bombing music, some some fucking Arabic music, normal music, rap
Nah,
music.
man, nah, man. We ain't fucking with that camel riding shit, man.
So you don't
And
listen to like some Arabic music and shit.
no, man, I don't bob my head to some fucking Arabian dance song when I'm riding my camel, man.
Why? That shit is dope though.
I like to listen to the fucking footsteps of the camel, man. It's soothing and calming to the ears.
Camel footsteps of whose phone was that?
It's obviously my phone, man.
Why? How unprofessional are you? Okay then, ring ring
Oh,
pussy, and it shut down. So yeah, so what were your early like influences? What did you listen to? Eminem.
don't know, man. I think I didn't know who the fuck these guys were. I just liked the vibe, and then I started listening to it, and then all of a sudden I knew what these like genres were, and then I was like, oh, okay, let's go in, boys. And then I started like hearing some gunshots and shit, and then I was like, oh, okay, this is rap. Let's vibe with this.
Okay, I think I came into rap a lot later. I was like 12 or 4, 12 to 14, 12 to 13, 14. Like I had been listening, hearing Ja Rule and like, Nas and Jay-Z, obviously. The one that really did it for me, I'm sorry, a lot of people will be pissed off, but it was Drake. I remember listening to So Far Gone, like The Calm, and I was just like, man, this nigga is speaking everything that I'm feeling right now. But in
Yeah.
terms of like first musical experience, it'd probably be Michael Jackson. My mom absolutely loved Michael Jackson, and she would play Thriller throughout the day. And I remember watching like the Thriller music video and crying my pants off. Like I would cry like a little bitch. And my
Oh
mother would
shit.
just be like, everybody like Michael Jackson, and you're here cry. I'm like, fam, this dude is turning into a fucking werewolf, and you expect me to be cool with that? And I was like freaked out by Michael Jackson. Like this was like when I was like,
Oh, yeah, I remember
four, five.
when we watched Thriller at night, and you were like, fuck, man, this shit gives me the creeps.
Yeah, because I could recollect like when I was four or five and I used to see him transform. I was like, yo, what kind of shit is this? But when I grew up and I started listening, I was like, this dude is dope. So early on, it was like Michael Jackson, Bob Marley, Fela, and then, some other like Akon was really big back then. So I was like a real like Akon stan. And obviously, Akon being from Senegal, like, I was about to say Niger.
Oh,
So
yeah,
yeah, all that
them
shit.
shout outs though, them shout outs though.
Yeah, shout out to Akon, man. He's doing
But
the,
dude,
he's a legitimate man.
when you think about it, like all these young, old, like people who are into music, like Michael Jackson, who was that white dude that was really popular with the chicks, man? The one with the fucking pelvis thrusting. Elvis, yeah. Yeah,
This,
that dude. Like,
can't
dude,
believe we
these
forgot
guys.
Elvis' name.
Dude, I don't know, man. But anyway, dude, like these dudes could pull chicks like no tomorrow, man. Like fucking, they would go and then when they're like, oh, okay, these guys are like out of the building, they'd be screaming and shit. Like, god damn, man.
But that's when being a
That's
megastar
when you
was
made
when,
it, man.
but being a megastar then was when you were a fucking megastar. Like people did not see these people on a daily basis. Now everything is watered down because you're seeing Drake posting a picture every day or a video every day, or you're seeing Rihanna post. Being a star now is not what it used to be. Like Michael
But dude,
Jackson would disappear for 4 years and then his
yeah.
album would drop and then he'd disappear for 4 years. Or there were times when women would lift up their skirts and show him their vagina. Like, that's when being a fucking star was that shit. And I
Yeah,
don't
but
think
dude,
you could
yeah.
ever replicate that.
But yeah, definitely. But then again, man, like the stars these days, they get more like DMs, man. They get more pussy pictures, whatever the fuck. But then
Nah.
again, no, it's not all like roses and sunshines, man. With the pussy pictures, you also get the dick pics from dudes trying to hustle, man.
But I
Like, imagine
think
fucking Drake, right? Going through like hundreds of fucking pussy DMs, and all of a sudden you got like a fucking 8-inch python in there, like, yo, Drake, what's up, my nigga?
why do I feel like you're speaking this out of experience? Like you'd be getting dick pics in your DMs or some shit.
Hey,
I'm
dude,
telling you, LA has done something to you, man.
I cannot either like confirm nor deny that fact, man.
And that's low. So you've been getting them dick DMs though.
I don't know, man. I can't confirm nor deny that.
But yeah, I think like being a star then was a lot more worthwhile. Now everything is like the attention span is so short. Like I got overwhelmed like last month when with the sheer and this month as well with the sheer amount of albums that were just coming out. I was like I couldn't keep up because you had Lemonade drop and then you had Views drop and then you had this drop and it was just like you lot need to chill. Let's absorb this music. And I have a friend who listened to Views for 1 week and then she's like, you know what, I'm over Views. What's the next album? I'm like, fam, do you know how I haven't even finished digesting this album? And while we're on the topic of Drake's album, me and you have a bone to pick.
All right, man,
Nothing
let's
was the
go.
same is better than Take Care. I don't
Nah,
care.
man, nah,
Nothing
man.
was
We
the
need.
same. Fam, do you know from start to finish, that album is classic. From start to finish. In Take Care, there are songs that I don't rate, like Over My Dead Body. But from start, Tuscan Leather, Furthest Thing, Started From the Bottom, Wu-Tang Forever, Own It, Worst Behavior, From Time, Hold On, We're Going Home, I didn't really like, Connect, The Language. You're gonna tell me this album is not a fucking classic. 16 tracks of just pure amazing music.
I don't know, dude. It's not like I'm shitting on Nothing Was the Same, but I just like the vibe and Take Care better, man. It fits my style of music better, man.
But it's the same vibe or nothing was the same, but more balanced.
Yeah, that's true too. Nothing Was the Same was more diverse, but you know, it's like that soft, chill song, that like type of fucking sex music. Like that's a vibe I like, man, and Take Care. So that really fits my style, man.
Take Care, the type of song that you'd be fucking your bitch and then just start crying. And it's just like, why are you crying? You're like, I'm just remembering my ex. Like Nothing Was the Same. You're fucking her with passion, you know. You're like, yeah, gonna get this dick. But
The fuck?
with Take Care, it's like you just break down halfway, like crying and shit.
Yeah,
But
man,
speaking,
you'll be fucking her, and then like one tear rolls down, and then it falls on her and shit.
but speaking of albums to have sex into. To have
Uh-huh.
sex with
Dude,
Division's album. Fuck.
dude. Dude, Division's
Fuck.
album. So you'll be fucking for 1 minute, man?
Division's album is like 8 track song. What are you saying, bruv?
It's an 8-track song, man, but can you go at that tempo, man?
What do you mean?
Wait, isn't it a high tempo album?
Division, they're signed to Drake.
Oh my days, man.
Are
I
you
got
going full
confused, man.
retard?
Nah,
Are
man, I
you
went full retard, man.
as usual? But yeah, Division's album, like I was playing this shit and I was listening to it. I was like, oh, I was like, it was giving me this vibe. I was like, damn, this song is good, and I'm just like going in for it. It was sad because the person wasn't even listening to the album. I'm like, so what do you think of the album? And it's like, no, I didn't even listen. And I was like, okay, so like what do we do now? But I
Oh
think
shit.
probably The Weeknd and
Trey
Trey
Songz,
Songz.
man.
Trey Songz,
What the fuck? Ain't
definitely.
nobody fucking to Ariana Grande.
No, she actually liked Ariana Grande's album. I was like,
But
okay,
dude,
like.
songs coming out like Dangerous Woman, like we can't vibe to that, man. It's like, oh, I feel like a danger, and then you're just like, okay then.
Vibing to like The Weeknd and Trey Songz. Those are guys that you
Dude,
have
you're the type
sex
of dude to be playing Lemonade while having sex, man.
with. No. I don't be playing Lemonade, man. Except maybe something like 6 inches. You can figure that long. That's the kind of shit that you take long strokes for. There's songs you take short strokes for, and then there's songs where you like pull back and then go in.
But dude, it's like it's fucked up when you get too attached to the music and then you're trying to fuck along the tempo of the music, man. It's like once the beat drops, like you go in ham, man. What
You're like do, do,
the
do, 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 do. As a rapid response, man. Sometimes you do that and then you feel like you're going Super Saiyan, man.
But dude, one thing I have a beef to pick with the chicks is like when you're starting to go in and then they're like, okay, I'm coming. But then like you try to come along with them and then when you're coming, they're not coming. Like, dude, don't say you're coming if you haven't came yet, man. It's like they're
Women.
coming and then you're fucking them for 5 minutes, they still haven't came, and then you're like, yo, man, why did you say you were coming when you're not gonna come for the next 10 minutes?
You know, my problem is that sometimes you do it and then you overdo it and then she doesn't come as, and then she's like, you ruined it. I'm like, what? I'm doing my best and you're telling me I ruined it. But it's like women have a very like peculiar body, like if you don't understand it. And that's why I was thinking maybe we need to teach sex in schools and at home, like actual sex, not just sex ed, but maybe like we need demonstrations of how to finger girls properly, how to actually have sex, because a lot of guys just jump into sex and don't know what to do.
Dude, in my honest opinion, do you know what a lot of guys lack, man? They lack that fucking tongue skill, man. It's like this is an RPG and they've like maxed out every other stat except the tongue skills, man.
Nah, man, I don't think guys even know how to finger properly.
Oh shit.
And
I
guys
don't
don't
know.
like to learn. We think we know everything. Like, I'd be watching videos on like YouTube or wherever, how to finger girls properly. I'd be like, oh, damn, that's how you do it. Okay. I'd be taking notes and shit. I'd be real serious when I do that shit, you know, put my glasses
You'll be
on,
putting your glasses on and shit. Be
taking notes.
fucking doing the finger exercises 5 minutes a day.
Yeah,
You wake
man.
up and then the first thing you do is like the come here motion for like 5 straight minutes, man.
Fam, I'm telling you, fingering can actually drain a man. If you finger a girl for like 15, 20 minutes, your arm is dead.
But dude, same thing for the tongue, man. It's like you're trying to go there for more than 5 plus minutes and then the tongue's all stiff and shit.
Think I have joined the grocery gang.
Oh
So,
shit.
you know how I used to give you shit for doing that? I finally joined.
Welcome, man. Welcome, man. It's a wonderful world we live in, man.
But you're still nasty as fuck, man. You're a hoe. At least I'm a loyal person, but you're a hoe. Ladies and gentlemen,
Let's not bring this, man.
ladies and gentlemen, in case you're wondering, I'm a loyal person, you know. I stick to one chick, you know, I do my shit. But this guy, Kai, he's a hoe. He will fuck like 10 girls in a week and he will betray his homies. I remember that one time I wanted to come to your place and you were
Oh
like,
my God, man,
no,
this
you don't
shit.
come to my place because I have someone over. I was like, nigga. I thought, what happened to homies over hoes? And you were like,
Dude,
no,
it
no,
was going down that night. What do you want me to do, man? Do you want me to make you wait in the closet or some shit while you hear us bang the next room?
hey, man, anything for your homie,
Dude, you'll be sitting there in the room listening to music, or even worse, man, you're listening to us.
I feel sorry for my roommates that had to listen to me have sex,
Oh
or
shit,
had to
man.
listen to the girl moan.
It depends, man. Are they Chinese, man?
No, you know my roommates before. When I was in Ahmadi's place. Shout out to Mr. Ahmadi, you're still there.
Shoutouts to Mr. Fucking Ahmadi, man. The guy who couldn't catch you for like 1 straight week, man.
God. 1 week. Well, more like 3 months.
No, dude, like you had her over for like a few weeks, didn't you?
Fam, let's just say our parents listened to this. We are very sorry that we have disappointed you.
Hey, dude. Hey, dude. What do you mean we, man? This is all you.
my parents be listening to this like, I did not bring him up like this. Where did you learn all of this? Like, I'm not ready for that phone call. They will be like, ah, Anwar, what is this podcasting that you are talking about sex?
But dude, one thing though, my gateway to get out of this shit is like fucking Africa, man. Where you headed to? China?
What do you mean you're heading to Africa?
Dude!
Like, what are you gonna do in Africa?
Dude, I disappear, man. Why else would one go to the depths of Africa, man? I ain't trying to ride no elephants, man. I already have my camel back home, man.
Why are
My
you
sweet,
go
sweet camel.
but why Africa? What are you gonna do in Africa? Like
Dude, where?
fucking join
Where?
Boko Haram or something?
Dude, I'm somewhere in between, man. I don't look full Arab, so I can't join ISIS. I don't look full Asian, so I can't join the Yakuza or some shit.
Yeah, that's the fucked up thing about you. You
So the
don't
only
look
thing left
white.
is Africa, man. They accept everybody, so might as well
But you're
go
not
in when I
black.
can.
But you're not black.
No, but they're very nice, so I can just be like, I can hustle my way in, man,
Oh,
somehow.
now Africans are very nice, yeah? When you
Dude,
were
I've
talk.
always said Africa was a nice place, man. Stop
Yeah,
twisting my words, man.
sure. But you won't fuck black chicks.
Oh,
I
shit.
have tried so hard to give you the black belt. You know what? The black belt.
Dude, you've never tried to hook me up, man. You're always hustling for yourself, man. What do you want me to
Man,
do?
A, fuck to you, and B, that's a big ass lie. But so let's talk about, how it is to fuck or get into relationships with girls from different places. 'Cause I've, kind of sort of had, crushes and things on girls that are from different places. With me, what I understand is I always go in like the first week, like, yo, I like you. 'Cause I don't like deceiving myself or deceiving you, like, I don't like you. I'm not gonna front. I'm gonna be like, yo, I like you. If you like me, cool. If you don't like me, that's okay. You know, that's usually how I go in. But with white chicks and with Asian chicks, you don't do that apparently.
No, definitely not there. Wait, I think we should give them the story about how it actually works out if you try to go in, right?
Like
The
that one
occurrence I'm talking
time.
about. Yeah, don't bring the name up, man. Let's make
No,
it.
I there will be no names here. There's only like two names or three names we will call here because we know those people will be cool.
Yeah, go for it. I think you should
No,
tell
no,
the
no.
story, man.
Which story? The one
This.
about the chick that didn't want to fuck me because apparently my dick would be too big for her.
No, not even. I forgot about that story, man. Okay, we can make that story and then the wingman story too, man.
Oh, about Le Pedro.
No, Le Pedro and Leroy, man.
Oh, what happened with Roy? You tell that story. I don't know what happened with Roy.
Oh, okay. You're gonna say this. All right, man. Say your story first, man.
With Pedro, where Pedro was trying. Peter has been trying for like 12, 18 months to get with an Asian chick, and it just was not working for him. He was
Dude,
like,
it wasn't 18 months, man. It was 9 months, and then all of a sudden,
why
God
couldn't you
decided to.
just let me go with the story, fam? We were, I was gonna exaggerate a little, but you've just, you're such a fucking
This guy, just give it,
bitch,
dude. 9 months is already too much, man.
man. 18
18,
months sounds
18,
cool.
18, he might as well be a hermit, man. He might as well chop his dick out and then chain it to his fucking neck, man.
Wait, are
He
you
has
a
no
hermit
use.
if you don't have sex for like 18 months?
No, you're not, but I mean, come on, man. You're
Like,
close to becoming that, man.
what's your drought period? What's been your longest like period without sex?
I'm a virgin, man. I'm pure as fuck.
So like 2 days, 3 days max.
Fuck you, man. What do you take me for, man? A fucking male prostitute.
Yes, definitely.
I would
Have you
like you
seen
to
your
know
hair?
that
Have you
I've.
seen your hairstyle? You look like a fucking gigolo. A fucking lesbian gigolo at that. I don't
Please,
know how that
man.
works out,
I
but
haven't
still.
hustled no chick yet. I'm a pure 100% virgin halal meat, man.
Sure. How's the chick, the one that starts with R?
Fuck you, man. There's no chick starting with R, man. There's all boys starting with R, man.
You fuck boys now on some pedophilia shit. Who's playing music?
Me, man. I
Why
brought it.
do you do this kind of retarded shit, man?
Dude, I don't
We're
know, man.
having a
I
podcast
shit
here,
you not. I
okay?
have a $1,000 guitar and I don't even know how to play it, man.
Anyway, so Pedro had been trying to get with Asian chicks because he has yellow fever. He's like, oh, the Asian chicks, I like, they don't like me. I just try to go with them and they tell me they don't like me because I'm black. And the funny thing is that he's not black, he's like Indian, he's Sri Lankan. It's like, what the fuck?
But dude, let me tell you, like, that occurrence that happened, man. Like, this was after he was vibing with a chick. Like, he was very courageous to give it to him. It's like, they had one class where, like, she was coming in and then he was going out. So he was, like,
I was
trying
there
to.
actually.
Oh, you were there?
Yeah.
Fuck, man. So I guess you can give a better,
No,
like,
just
insight into it,
talk.
yeah?
Continue.
Yeah, basically, so the chick was getting ready for a class, right? And then he all of a sudden was like, yo, I really like you. Can I take your number? And then, dude, the thing with Asian chicks is like, even if they don't fuck with you, like once they're put on the spot, they have to give you the number, man. Unless they try the card, like, oh, me no speak English, and then they fuck off, man. But she gave him her number, and then he was like, oh, I'm getting some pussy this weekend, and then he started like messaging her and shit. It's like all good. Dude, this guy's a fucking retard, man.
You know
So
the thing
he.
with chicks, just to interject, when they know you want the pussy, they'll delay and delay to see if you really want them. And then when they're ready, they'll like just pop it for you. Just be like, I thought you didn't want to fuck. It's like, oh no, they were just like testing you. So just a quick like advice to guys, don't just lose hope if you don't get pussy like the first 2 weeks. Keep on it.
But yeah, man, so he added her on this fucking Chinese social app, right?
You
And
mean WeChat?
yeah, WeChat, whatever the fuck its name is, right? So as soon as you add somebody, a fucking text pops up, right? Where like, oh,
Oh yeah.
we have become friends, and then we can start chatting. The fucking retard thought the girl sent this shit and he messaged her first. He was like gassed up. He was like, yo, man, she messaged me first. I'm getting some pussy tonight.
Actually, speaking of messaging, when do you think is the appropriate time to message a girl after you get like her number or something?
Dude, I think if not the next 15 minutes on some like fucking on some funny shit, it's like, yo, I'm sorry for like looking like a creep, but I really wanted to holler at you, some shit like that. If you try to play it out, dude, girls are even worse, man.
Man is dropping them hints, you know? Actually, for me and something that I discussed with Yash, she was like, when you do it, just leave it till the night after or the following day, because you don't want to seem like you're too desperate.
Yeah, that's true.
But sometimes when you text a girl or you interact with a girl, it just works out. Like with Yash, I didn't really need to like consistently text her. Like it just happened. Like sometimes it would just happen, and sometimes you need to put effort. I'd say like if you text her like the conversation goes, then just let her text you because she will like to talk to you. But sometimes, you know, just leave it for a couple of days, let it simmer, and then text her back and then leave it again. But these days chicks don't like calling, and that had always like bothered me. Like obviously now I don't really care if you chicks want to call me, like
I
chicks
think it's
that.
because, yeah, the fucking text game is too strong these days. It's like people don't want you to call them anymore. It's like, yo, man, I'm trying to hit them up, and then like they don't answer the call, and then they're like, yo, dog, why are you calling? Like, what the fuck, dude? Like, I'm calling.
I think like our generation is gonna have the shortest attention span ever. Like our attention span is like 30 seconds. And
No, dude.
that's strange for me because I can watch like hour long, 2 hour long specials or interviews or podcasts. I like that kind of shit. But a lot of people can't, you know, focus if it's longer than 30 seconds. Like our audience has already zoned out of this conversation. Like she's already bored. But like most people can't stay in it for longer than 30 seconds.
But dude, do you think it's something about attention span? For me, I think it's like people don't like confrontations, man. It's like when you call somebody, right? When you call somebody, right? It's like you're there at the moment. This could work out for you or against you, depending on the type of chick you're trying to get. So let's say, for example, like you call her and then you're like, yo, you want to go out for a date tonight? She can't like see the text and then ignore you, man. She has to reply. So depending on what type of girl she is, you might get it then and there, or you have to play the fucking text game, which is annoying as
While
fuck,
I
man.
agree with you, what I'm saying is still related. Because we have text, because we have things like, you know, texting and Instagram and whatever, we don't have that attention span to carry a conversation on the phone.
Yeah, that's true. That's true.
Most people you talk to on the phone can't hold a conversation for longer than a minute.
Yeah, that's true too.
Like, that's why I'm surprised, like, with you or with, like, you know, her. Like we can have like a day long conversation and we're not bored. Obviously, we'll take like pauses where we won't say anything for like a few minutes, but it's very rare to see people who have that attention span or have that, you know, skill to converse now. It's now a skill to be able to hold a conversation.
Dude, I think it's because like people think it's weird to have a quiet moment, man. It's like, okay, if you're out with somebody, right, and then there's like a gap of silence, it's weird. Like, you guys should just be comfortable, like, I
Yeah,
don't know,
that's
man.
dope. Sometimes you don't need to say anything. Just feel the vibe and feel the energy of the person you're with. We want to do everything and have everything to show the world. It's like, just chill, you know? Just
Yeah,
chill.
that's
Let's sit
true.
down. Let's vibe. Let's smile at each other, you know? Let's look each other in the eye. We don't need to post shit on Instagram. Like, they don't. We're posting. Like, the quote that keeps resonating with me is that we do things for people that we don't even like. Like, what's
Yeah,
the
that's
point of
true.
posting a picture on Instagram so that you get a bunch of likes from people who don't care about you, you know?
Wait,
So just
is this for girls or is this for guys?
for both,
Or
I
for
think.
both, huh?
That's why I don't rate it when the relationship is like you can tell everything is on. That's why I don't rate it when, you know, our friend posts that shit on Facebook. I told him, why are you posting this on Facebook? If you really feel this way, call her or text her that you feel that.
Yeah, that's true. That's
That's
true.
why
I
I
don't know, man. I think people, for guys, like if we're talking about this particular person, right? It's like they don't know who to go to, or they just want to like suck up some attention. But for girls, like I've talked to girls, I've like seen them post shit up online, then gets a lot of likes. I'm like, why do you do this? They're like, oh, I like the attention because like I have this now. If 20 years later, of course they're old and like their fucking tits are sagging shit now, so they won't get as much attention as they get now. So they want to thrive off of it now, and then yeah, basically they crave attention, man. So
That's why I'm happy with where I'm at, where the person can doesn't even let me be angry too long. Like she doesn't even
yeah.
give me like 5 minutes to be too angry, and we can just settle our issues there and then and move the fuck on. Like
Yeah.
obviously we're gonna fight, that's normal, but let's just settle the issue. And if you're with someone and that person isn't giving you the attention, then maybe you need to look for someone else, to be honest.
Yeah, that's very true.
While
But
we're
dude,
on the
like,
topic of Oh, what do you want to say?
no, I just wanted to say, like, let's say, for example, you have two types of girls that you're going after, right? One, like, you just go straight out and you're like, oh, I really like you, like talking to you. This is after like a short conversation, whatever, yeah? And then you're like, can we go for a date tonight? Rather than the other type of girl where you have to, like, you know, play it out with her for like 1, 2 weeks and then you can go out on a date. Is there like difference? Like, is the first type of girl considered a hoe? And then the other type of girl considered innocent, or it doesn't
So,
really matter.
what are you saying? The first type of girl just goes out on a date immediately and the other takes more time?
Yeah.
No. I think it just comes down to the situation and the mood.
Yeah, exactly. I
It
don't know,
really
dude.
comes
Like,
down
yeah.
because sometimes you can vibe with someone so well that you will get that person in a day. Like you will feel that vibe, that chemistry being there from one conversation.
Yeah, that's very
And
true.
sometimes it's more gradual and you feel it over a long period of time.
Yeah. Now,
But
is she considered a hoe for giving up on the first date
no.
or not? Yeah,
I don't
exactly,
think
right?
I think men and women can be hoes, and it depends on how much like how you consider sex. To me, sex is something that you share with someone who you have deep feeling for, and there's a passion there, and there's like it's not like you're just doing it so that you can come, you know?
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. But
But dude, about coming though, have you heard about this type of shit where like
Oh
guys
God.
fake orgasms, man?
Oh God. How
Like,
do you fake orgasm?
dude, how do guys fake orgasms, man? It's not like I have a fucking water gun underneath my dick when the girl's not looking. She's like looking up at the ceiling, and then I like fucking spray it out and go,
Oh
oh,
yeah,
I
I
can't.
know you laugh at looking up at the ceiling.
What?
The person knows who I'm talking
Oh shit, that's sad.
to.
But yeah, dude, like, how the fuck are guys meant to come, man? And ladies, if your guy can't make you come, you shouldn't fucking lie about it and act it out rather than telling him to his
You
face,
know, when
man.
I found out that women fake orgasms, I became so like insecure about the whole thing. Like
Yeah.
even now I'm like, is she lying to me? Is she like inflating my ego? Are you
Yeah.
sure you really care? Like I'd be asking like two or three times and be like, are you sure you care? Because you don't know. She could be like, oh
You'll be going down there with a magnifier looking for like
it's
fluids and shit.
No, but sometimes you can tell though. Sometimes I don't think you can fake the body reaction. I think the
No, I don't
moaning
think so.
and the
Yeah.
saying it, but you can't. So where we're on this topic, there's a double standard I have a problem with. So
Yeah,
have you
what
noticed
is?
how women push men's buttons, but men aren't necessarily allowed to push a woman's button?
Yeah, I've noticed this, dude.
And what do you think why do you think they do that?
Dude, I think this just boils down to the fact that for us guys, we gotta have that pussy, man. Like,
I
give,
think
take, it's stronger, man. It's like if they're really pissed off, dude, they can go without the dick for like days upon days, man.
Yeah, that's
But
true.
we're gonna fake it for one day. We're like, fuck this bitch, man. I don't want her pussy no more. And then the second day you come like a fucking puppy, man. You're just like the
Okay then. That
fucking
moan
you're
though.
fucking
Okay.
thirsty. You're thirsty as fuck, man.
Now the
So
whole
then you're
world
just like,
knows. Now the whole world knows what you sound like when you orgasm.
I wasn't orgasming, man. I was faking that fucking puppy noise where they have the tongue out, man.
I think when men push women's button, we're just being retarded. Like, we don't sit down and be like, you know what? I'm going to tell her her left tit is sagging in her right tit. Like, we don't sit down and think through. We just be like stupid and we say something stupid and we immediately realize. But women will deliberately sit down, understand what pisses you off, and then do that exact same thing. And they don't do it once, they don't do it twice. They can do it like 10 times in a day. And when you get angry, they're like, oh my God, why are you angry? It's like, bitch, you know why I'm angry. You did that shit that I don't like. And it's like, okay, I'm supposed to deal with it because I'm a man. But if I push your button, you won't talk to me for like 3 days or a week.
Yeah, man. I don't know, man. Like, the power of the pussy is too strong, man.
But,
like,
yeah.
Like, I gotta go train with some, like, Tibetan monks, man. Get my, like... Dude, those guys do some fucked up training, man. It's like they wake up in the morning and then all of a sudden you get 10 kicks to the balls to, like, fucking neglect for that. Like, getting control. Yeah?
What? I think as Asians, you lot can do that. But as a black man, you know, man's dick is too, you know...
It's not about the dick, man. I'm pretty sure the ball is located at the same fucking position, man. Stop bringing that shit, man. It's not like you have one type of shield coming out in front of your balls, be like, no, no pussy. Fuck you, man.
What the fuck accent was that?
I don't know, man. That was an Italian accent, man. Apparently, like, black dudes have, like, fucking Italian mafiosos guarding their balls, man.
Okay, then. And other, so while we were talking about, I really do believe, though, we should teach about sex and relationships at home and, like, in school. Because as a man, I was never taught how to handle rejection, how to handle a girl telling me no. And this is not something to be like, oh, people who go and rape people are right. They're fucking wrong. It's disgusting. Yeah, but at course, the same time, you still have to acknowledge the fact that these things aren't taught in society.
I mean, it's very true. Like, nobody ever teaches you, like, oh, like, they all teach you how to, like, you know, fish, but they don't tell you how to fish with that pussy, if you know what I'm saying. Okay, let's rewind this for a minute, man. That went down the wrong track, man. I was about to say, okay, I give you the pussy for one day, but if you don't teach me how to get the pussy for everything, fuck my life.
the Asian accent did not help, man.
I don't know where this is going, man.
No, but it's true. We don't teach that. You're not taught. You're not taught how to deal with a woman. You're not taught how to, croon or, you know, charm a woman. You're not taught how to handle her saying no. Women aren't taught how to deal with men. We're not taught how to, you know, do certain things. And you end up having a situation where you can't handle that depression. And you feel like there's no one to talk to. And I've seen so many situations and it's depressing because even I at the time was like, oh, this chick's told me no, you know, what is life, you know. We've all gone through that.
But dude, this goes back to that advice that I gave a particular someone. It's like when you go out and then you ask a chick out, right? Mm-hmm. And she ends up rejecting you. She's just rejecting you at like face value. Mm-hmm. So it's not like she knows you inside out and then she rejects your whole being. If she just rejects you on a face value, then that's all right. I mean, people are attracted by looks. So if she doesn't vibe with the way you look, you can't, like, blame her for that. I mean, you went in for the exact same reason. You like the way she looks.
Not even just talking about initial rejection. It's also talking about rejection on a long term.
Like, oh, rejection on a long term, yeah.
Like, you guys, get used to like that. The friend zone. Like, you spend time maybe 2-3 weeks. You tell the girl you like her. And then she tells you, you know, you're dope, you're this, but that crushes you. Or, you know, you tell her you like her and then suddenly she becomes more distant. That crushes you. You know, you don't know how to handle these things. And you don't know how to handle the way women are different from men and how to respect them is that. I was privileged to spend a lot of time with my mom. So I had immense respect for women from the jump because I saw how my mom handled her shit and the way she is. And I'm grateful for that because that has helped the way I treat women. But not everybody has that upbringing. And if we don't, like, spread the word or tell people that it needs to be taught, it won't be taught.
Yeah, exactly. I don't know, man. It's like different countries, they're weird about these type of things. It's like what happened down at that party, man, when that guy, laid his hands on his girlfriend, dude. That was
a memorable night. When you were trying, when I was trying to prevent you from fighting, and then I was about to swing on the dude.
Yeah, dude, that shit was fucked up, man. Like, let's break this down. Like, everybody, basically, we were at a type of gathering.
I like how you said everybody, like, we have more than 10 listeners or something.
Hey, dude, everybody to me is like more than two people, man, which is the current case. So, come on. Anyway, we were at a gathering to support a friend. He was there, like, hustling his music.
Oh, whatever, dude, should we talk about the dance?
dude, let's not bring that, man. This is a fucking black box.
I always love when Pedro faces obstacles in his life, man.
Dude, I shit you not, man. I was like, yo, Pedro, I'm going to make this joke to Serena, right? He was like, yo, my brother, don't bring this shit out, yo. And I was like, all right, man. It was when that, like, desperate cry for help came, man.
Man,
like,
but
okay,
shout
this is
out
something I can't touch.
Shout out to Pedro and Serena. Their relationship has to be the most entertaining relationship I've ever seen in my life, man.
Shout outs to Serena getting insecure by me telling her she has this fishy pussy, man.
Oh God, what? When did this happen?
I shit you not, man. I was being a jackass, right? Texting shit to Serena, like, oh, Peter says, like, your pussy smells like fish and shit. And she was, like, trying to banter me, but I knew I got to her, man.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is why I say, A, you're a hoe, and B, you're the devil's incarnate.
Hey, dude, fucking Serena ticks all of my boxes, man. You know how... Anyway, dude, let's get to this situation with this dude, right? Anyway, so me, Anwar, and one Russian dude, we're like sitting outside. Yeah, the big Russian dude, man. I forgot his name.
Alex?
We fucking gave him fucked up names like AK and Kalashnikov, man. I blame you for this.
Dimitri. My name is Dimitri.
I have the Kalashnikov.
It's Soviet Russia. God don't shoot you. You shoot God. I know that sounded retarded. It was meant to be the other way around.
In Soviet Russia, we fuck the milk, we drink the vodka.
What? We fuck the milk and drink the vodka.
Dude, I don't know where we're going with this. But basically, yeah, we were sitting in the back, right? So all of a sudden, we see a guy rushing with his girlfriend into the fucking backyard garden type area where people, like, were making out and shit. And he, like, fucking pushes her into the ground. This chick tried to come up and, like, hustle for her life. She got thrown down again. And all of a sudden,
you forgot Rudy.
Oh, dude, he comes later. Me and Alex were just sitting there. We were like, what the fuck is going on? Is this happening? Is that a dude or is that a chick, man? Like, we couldn't see. It was that dark. So all of a sudden, we see this one, like, Asian dude come run over. He was our friend. He was like, oh, fuck you. Why did you stop touching her? Whatever the fuck. And we were like, yo, what the fuck is going down? So we took the chick. And then all of a sudden, two other chicks came over. And now this is like a fucking face-off. It's... us and our gang, like, I shit you not, 6-7 guys ready to whoop this dude's ass.
Versus one Chinese dude with, like, three Asian girls surrounding him.
He's like 187, whatever, right? But ain't no way he's getting out of, like, any one of us 1v1 or, like, the six guys behind us. So basically, he was behind his girlfriend and two of his girlfriend's friends. So it was a barricade of three girls, and he behind was like, oh... Come fight me, come fight me. Fuck you, man.
It's not your business. It's not your business. I'm like, fam, do you want these guys to fuck you up? It's like, it's not your business. It's not your business. Then, like,
and dude,
three
I was
girls
like the peacemaker,
like,
man.
No. You're mistaken. Three girls were, like, in front protecting him, and then Richard was Rody first went. I'm like, Rody, it's not worth fighting in Uni Lodge. I pushed him away. Then all of a sudden, I see Richard turning red. I'm like, what the fuck is going on? And then Richard wants to fight. I drag Richard away. And then you, like, were like, oh yeah, you want to go, bro? You want to go? I'm like, okay, Kai, calm the fuck
down.
And then I drag you away.
Man.
And then the dude wanted to come at me. He wanted to come at me. I'm like, fam, I just saved you from an ass whooping of your lifetime and you want to fight me. And then he was like, it's not your business. Come fight me. I now took off my hoodie. It like touched the ground. I was about to swing. And then you came and grabbed my hand. I was like, why didn't you just let me punch this dude in the face, man?
Dude, one thing I forgot to tell you guys, like, these chicks, right? They were like listening to Yogi sing, and I saw their faces and they like looked at our direction. So they were like quite nice, right? I shit you not, man. When I was like up against that guy, I gave all of them that fucked up look I have. You know the one where I like
I don't think people know the fucked up look you
where I
have.
fucking Westwood the shit out of my eyes, man, the devil's eye.
Oh,
And
yeah.
then, dude, I think I saw them, and they were so shit scared that I think one of them urinated, man.
Shout out to Yogi, man. Yogi be getting all the Asian pussy, even though he
Dude,
doesn't really get the pussy, but still.
dude, dude. Yogi was given multiple pussy access card. It was like fucking the chicks, right? All of them gave them the
Oh.
fucking pussy card where he would like swipe and they'd get access,
Can you
but he used
see?
none of it.
Can you see how life is fucked up? Peter, his best friend, was looking for Asian pussy but couldn't get, and him, the Asian, was getting all the Asian pussy but didn't want to fuck anybody. Can
Dude,
you see
even
like how life is?
dude, I don't
That's
know.
why
I
I
don't know.
believe when they say when you want something, don't look for it.
Oh, dude, one thing that I didn't remember about that night, dude. Oh yeah. Oh fuck, dude, this is fucked up. Like, you remember after the show, all the chicks wanted to take picture with Yogi and his friend, right? And nobody wanted to take pictures with Peter, man. So Peter must have seen them at one moment in time. And he was like, "These
I'm sorry,
motherfuckers."
but if you are still racist in 2016, like something is fucking wrong with you, man. Especially racist towards black people. I mean, come on, we have tried our shit for how many hundreds of years, been slaves, fought for civil rights, been at the back of the bus, all that shit. And we have progressed so far as a humanity. And if you're still racist at this point, with all the media that is available to you, like, you're fucking retarded. I'm sorry. Because I can't understand why you would still be racist at this juncture. Like, everybody wears Air Jordans, everybody watches basketball, everybody likes kung fu movies, everybody likes fucking America. So why are we still racist? I can't,
Dude.
it doesn't work in my head. I can't understand it.
Dude, I like your argument where, like, if fucking Chinese people are racist towards black people, they shouldn't fuck with Pop or Air Jordans, man.
Like,
I
nigga, do you know outside of the United States, China is like the largest consumer of hip hop? They're
Yeah,
the
of
ones
course.
who buy the most. Like, dude, do you know how many Asians I've seen with Yeezys? Like, I've never seen black people wear Yeezys. I've only seen Asians wear Yeezys. Air Jordans, they line up for that shit. They watch basketball more than me. I don't even watch basketball. They play that shit. And you're still fucking racist. Like, it makes no sense to me. Like, I will watch a Bollywood movie, I will watch a fucking American movie, watch like shit like that, because it's interesting to see how people work differently. Like,
Yeah.
that's the world we live in. You can learn about what goes on right now in fucking China, and you're in America. That's how the world has been. So I can't understand why you would still be racist. And even fucking your people are pretty racist as well, Kai. Like, Arabs are fucking like disgustingly racist. If not for the fact that black people are Muslim as well, I'd say they're more racist than fucking white people.
Dude, are they? What have you experienced, man?
In Saudi Arabia, if you overstay your visa and you're black, they take you to the fucking desert, dig the sand, bury you in sand for like 3 days under the scorching sun.
Are you
Imagine,
sure? Are you sure this
imagine.
wasn't like hustle? Dude, Saudi Arabia does a lot of fucked up things, man. I can't be
Man,
accounted for all of this shit.
I can't
I mean,
rate
I'm just
that.
here riding my camel, man. Come on. Even though my camel was imported from Saudi Arabia, but then
Yeah.
hey.
Your camel was, how do you import a camel?
I don't know, man. There's a lot of like paperwork in, man. You have to like fucking get a camel masturbator. They have to release sometime, man. So you
Dude,
gotta give them that.
what the fuck is, I'm not even gonna ask because I don't really want to know.
Dude, it's up there, man, but
I
basically a
don't need
camel.
to, we don't need
Dude,
to know this.
listen.
We
A
don't need to know
camel
this. We
reliever is
do not
someone
need
who
to know this, okay? We don't need to know this. So,
shout out
yeah.
to all the camel relievers.
Man, they should do rodeos in fucking Arabia with camels, man. The way they do cowboy rodeos, they should do the same camel rodeos.
Dude, if they did that, nobody would get out with their balls intact, man, with the fucking humps, man.
But shout out to Dubai. Dubai is an amazing place. That's why sometimes, like, when people be like, oh, I am Muslim, I don't eat the pork. I'm like, fam, you drink and smoke and fuck bitches before you get married, but you won't eat pork. Like, what's
Dude,
the logic behind
this is
that?
like that shit that was fucked up, man. It was like, okay, this guy's drinking, he's fucking bitches right in front of me, and then I asked the fucker what he's eating. He's like, oh, everything except pork. I'm
Wait,
like, bitch, please.
he was fucking a bitch in front of you?
No, dude, but you know what I mean, man.
If
Like,
I'm forced to have a three-way, it would never be with you, by the way. Never. I would never have a three-way with your girl.
Knowing you, you'd probably grab an Asian dude with a 2.5-inch penis, you dirty fucker.
I don't think I could ever have a three-way with another man, man. I don't want to see another man like.
Dude, but we've discussed this, man. A three-way. Oh, no, you didn't say
Sorry,
three-way. Sorry,
run a train.
A train,
with a girl.
yeah.
I would never do that.
Dude, the thing is, run a train. You never run a train on one you really love. And secondly, you ain't doing it with someone who
Fair,
has a bigger
fair.
penis than you, man.
You never do
Dude,
it with someone you love. Yeah.
The last thing you want to be doing is you jacking off to the side while this chick is moaning at the tips of her fucking lungs to some guy who's banging the shit out of her, man.
Science doesn't matter. It's the motion of the ocean.
Dude, this is all bullshit, man.
Fam, your penis can be fucking 4 inches and you can make a girl cock. Just subscribe to my tutorial on how to make a pussy wet.
Dude, if you've ever seen a fucking guy with a four inch dick, you better tell him to stick his tongue out, man, because I'm pretty sure his tongue is worked out, man. His tongue be looking like the biceps of Arnold Schwarzenegger, man.
Okay, then. That's not an image you want in your head. Because how would that fit in your mouth? We were talking like this all the time.
I don't know, man, but his mouth will get well adapted to holding that fucking monster of a tongue, man, for the amount of times he's gone down, man. Shout out to that tongue skill, by the way.
Yeah, hey, man, going down doesn't mean you have to use tongue. You know, you can use your fingers as well.
I mean, surely, man, but you know, when you bring the tongue out, you know it's going down, man.
I don't know. I don't know. Let me not go too much into that. But yeah, I guess, yeah. I don't know what I'm gonna say next. So do you want to talk about sport? Because I'm not really well versed in that.
I mean, is there anything else we wanted to talk about, like sex and all this other thing?
I see you like the sex topic.
Obviously, man. Wait. Do 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 do. Should we?
I don't.
Should
I don't
should
like.
Should we give like a few advices on this shit? Oh yeah.
Yeah, you can give advice because you're.
Dude, I need to give this advice, dude, because Thailand was fucked up at one time, right?
Oh God, here we go.
Thailand
again.
Thailand at one time was considered among the top three in which like teenagers were getting pregnant. But anyway, man, so these guys were like, what the fuck are these guys doing, man? They're like, we're the top three in the world for teenagers getting pregnant. So dude, these guys got so fucking crazy, man. They started like giving out condoms in fucking high schools throughout universities, man.
I rate that.
I rate that too, man. You can never have enough condoms, man.
Dude, when you make sure you don't have sex in Atlanta. Apparently, that has like an astronomically high rate of HIV.
Yeah. But dude, like, dude, this HIV shit, it's not like, oh, okay. Oh, yo, dog, I got HIV today. Like, dude, you go to areas where like chicks get fucked up in bad ways and then you get HIV. You're not gonna go to a fucking library and then get HIV off of some chick, man. Unless you get really unlucky and then you get a hoe
used to say in Nigeria, you know they show for face. Meaning it doesn't show on your face. You know what I used to think a condom was? I swear to God I was retarded when I was younger. I used to think a condom was a type of air conditioning that people with HIV needed so that it would blow like air, like a different kind of air on them. So whenever they said, oh, you need a condom, I was like, oh, so you have to buy a different kind of AC for people who have HIV. Just so I put that out there. But yeah, man, I wanted to talk about police not taking shit seriously. Like, whenever there's a case, you go to the police and they're like, oh, it's just a minor case, you know. And then when shit pops off, they're like, why didn't you report to the police? Bitch, we reported to the police and you didn't take it seriously enough. And now when shit actually goes down, you're like, oh, you should have reported to the police. Like, I've never understood that logic.
Dude, the way the police works, it's like they come in after the fact, man. They're never there before the fact it happens. They're not there to, like, prevent the shit, man, in most cases.
Man.
They're just there to, like, oh, okay, this happened. Okay, it's easier for investigation.
And then they shoot people up when shit happens, like, they can't control themselves. But before a crime is committed, you tell them, like, in a preemptive attempt, and no action is taken. That frustrates me.
Yeah, dude, I don't know, man. But, like, shout out to all the good cops, man. We can't just, like, underplay them for all of the shit, like, the... It's like what I say
I like what you're doing here. You don't want to get shot tomorrow.
Hey, dude, I gotta make like my plans, man. Donald Trump might want me to suck his dick by the end of next week, man. I never know,
I
so.
like how you keep referencing sucking dick. You must really, LA has done something to you, man. You like sucking dick now.
Dude, this coming from the guy who would suck dick for like a few million, huh? You
Hey,
better shut the
that's
fuck
not
up,
what
man.
that was not the conversation we had. Conversation we had was, would you take it up the ass if you had like guaranteed success? I didn't answer. We were both like weighing out the pros and cons, but I never said
Dude,
yes or no.
was the convo was like a rich millionaire like drives up in a fucking limousine, lowers his window, and then like takes off like he's this motherfucker is gassed up wearing like sunglasses, and then he takes you know that move where they take their sunglasses down and then wink at you. It's
Okay,
like what the fuck, man? Was that
this sounds
type
very
of
well
scenario?
rehearsed. This sounds very well rehearsed. Dude, you know what I do? Take the money and then said he raped me. I'd go on Oprah and Ellen and shit, be like, and then he put his dick in my ass.
And dude, just to hustle, like you fucking go home, take like the biggest zucchini you could hustle out of a supermarket, and then shove that shit up your
Okay,
ass.
I'm not that committed to that life, man. I'm not that committed.
Hey, dude, if you're going in, you might as well go in all the way, man.
All right, okay. I just want to say that relationships, sex, all of that is between you and your partner. Understand yourself and understand your partner. Not everything that works for someone else will work for you. Have the
Of
patience to
course, yeah.
understand each other and know that it's your thing. No one else, it's no one's business. Solve your problems yourself. Talk to your partner, understand each other, and you know, whatever happens will happen. And you might have a great relationship or you might learn from it if it doesn't work out. Like, you know, just don't feel the pressure of having to do what everybody else is doing. Grow at
Very
your own
true.
pace and grow together. These days, men are being too scared to be men because of what social media tells them, and women are being too scared to be women. Just be yourselves, and you will eventually find that person who loves you for who you are. And tolerates both your good shit and your bad shit.
But dude, like, even though how far we've came, like, it's really weird still, like, when it's like when I saw my like one Chinese dude who just got off of China, we call them fobs. So he was like, oh dude, I saw this like Asian dude with like a hot blonde chick, and I was like really impressed and jealous. I was like, dude, what the fuck, man? Just because you're Asian, it doesn't mean you can't hustle like, oh,
Yeah.
a Latino chick or like a white chick or like a black chick. Like, what the fuck, man?
Yeah, when this chick, like, when you see, like, for me, when she was like, I like you, I'm like, oh, you like me. Me, like, the annoying, you know, sometimes weird me. Like, I was like, okay, are you sure? Because you can't take that back now that you've said it. Because you need to be sure that you mean that you like me. Because,
You
you
gotta
know,
take responsibility.
sometimes you downplay yourself and you don't know what you're really worth. But someone,
Yeah.
somewhere, you know, when the time is right, you will meet that person who knows what you're worth and will accept you for who you are and what you are as a person. So don't
Man.
feel like you need to, you know, overachieve or overcorrect yourself.
Very true, very true. But dude, shout outs to like all the interracial couples, man. Shout outs to Serena for trying that black piece of meat. Shout outs to every girl that got hustled by
Once
like
you go
a dick
black,
that
you don't
doesn't
go back. Yeah.
Oh,
There ain't no
oh
mercy in
shit.
this. You ain't going nowhere, fam.
Oh
Man is kidnapping you to Nigeria.
shit.
You will go and learn how to eat jollof rice.
All of a sudden, she looks out of the window and there's like fucking lions and shit, man. That's what she knows, man.
Okay, these lions though. Shut up. Nobody, your opinion
What?
is not needed here.
But dude, about this lion shit, man. Like, dude, now that I think about it, that fucking that time I roasted Peter was fucked up, yo. It was like 3 straight hours, man. I should you know, we went from dinner started at 6, and I was harassing him from 6 till 11, man. We went to dinner. As soon as any of the waiters comes, I would like tell them, yo man, wait here. They were all girls, right? So I would be like, yo, do you see this guy? Where is he from? And then I would give them options if they were like too afraid to say. I was like, Italy. I dude, one chick I said Italy, she like looked funnily at me like, Italy, this guy. Oh, Africa, 100%.
Miss
dude. I was like
Africa.
Africa or India. Most of them were like India, and then most of them were like Africa. And this guy was like, "What the fuck?" And then one chick was like, "Oh, okay, Italy." And then I was like, "Okay, this guy looks like he just got off of a fucking lion, man." And then everybody went gas. This guy like went out, like, dude, that night was fucked up, yo.
But I like how Pedro is the bitch of the group that everyone just roasts. We need to. I don't think we can find another bitch in that group because everybody actually knows how to roast besides him.
Dude, I think if it's not Peter that's going down, I think it's Richard that's going down, man.
Because me and you, we'd have a solid, like, we have, like, solid...
We'd cancel each other out, man.
Yeah. Shout out to Black Panther, the king of Wakanda.
Oh, dude, I don't know how Black Panther came into play, man.
Black Panther,
Did he take your anal card?
Okay, then. I am super excited for Black Panther. I cannot be, like, I am so gassed for Black Panther. It's going to be... Michael B. Jordan is going to be in it. Who else? Lupita Nyong'o. I don't really rate her. You know,
are you taking your significant other to see it, or do you want to go by yourself so you can let down?
No, she's gonna watch Black Panther.
So you're gonna let down all those like manly tears, man.
No. She's gonna see Black Panther, even though she doesn't like comics, but she's gonna watch that. But the thing, you know how you said you rate Michael B. Jordan? I was like, man, the guy is a very good actor, man. After watching like Creed and Fruitvale Station, yeah, he's a good actor.
Like, dude, and he's been getting a lot of attention, man, from, like, all the chicks in Hollywood, man. They all want to write that Michael B. Jordan dick, man.
Everybody want to write that black dick, you know? There's something about this black dick.
Oh, my days.
So what are we talking about next?
I think we should go on to the sports section, right?
You're taking over that section.
Or you want to give out, like, what's been going on around the world, man?
No, man. Nothing really interesting besides the Egyptian plane that crashed and
Donald... Dude, let's just talk slightly on this dude, like,
oh,
what
yeah,
the
yeah,
fuck,
yeah.
Man?
I actually wanted to say something. Bare like Illuminati shit has been going on these days.
Yo, man. yo, don't bring the Illuminati so
we
early,
need
man.
We need to summon the other day me and we were talking and then we just found out like numbers and shit and how they're related to us, like numbers be having a significance issue, but like all these planes that have been crashing and going missing and shit, like it seems very shady and no one is gonna be like, oh, let's pray for Egypt. Like I remember when the plane crashed in Russia and no one trended like pray for Russia. But like a week later, some shit happened in France and everybody was like, pray for Paris. Like, I don't like that selective, like,
Dude,
selective
you know
empathy.
Thing? You know the messed up thing? I think most of these people who are like, oh, pray for France, pray for like Belgium, whatever, right? Mm. They do it to like follow the trend, man. Like it's some sort of sick trend that's going on, man.
That's why if you have that green, if you have that France filter on your Facebook, I'd be looking at you a certain type of way because it's like, you really feel that or you just bandwagon effect. Speaking of bandwagon, did you see like the COD, the new COD Infinity whatever trailer?
I don't know, man. I stopped following COD, Battlefield, wherever. I just played
it's,
football.
It's
so
now the most, it's now the most disliked video on YouTube, I think.
Oh shit, how come?
Because... You know, bandwagon effect and the fact that Battlefield trailer came out and the fact that it's futuristic COD and apparently people are tired of futuristic COD.
Dude, apparently like Battlefield 1 is whooping everybody's shooter game ass, man.
But let's not go too far. What were we talking about?
Yeah, we're just going to talk about
the
flight. Dude,
flight, yeah.
Dude, this shit is fucked, man. It's like I'm making my way back to like Thailand and my motherland in like a fucking few months and now it's... Plane crash, you know how I be in the fucking planes, man. I don't do plane rides well, man.
Yeah.
If I could, I shit you not.
I like how all my friends are little bitches on planes. I really like
Dude,
that.
I shit you not, man. When the fucking turbulence occurs, I clench my asshole so hard, man. Like it's gonna fucking help me.
It's turbulence, it's like, not a dick. Calm down, okay?
It's like if the plane drops, like clenching my asshole does something for the situation,
it's
man.
It's not a dick, Kai. You don't need to clench.
Like,
your
dude,
asshole.
I'm 30,000 feet in the air. I'm like, oh, okay. Like, if I stress,
I'm pretty sure clenching your asshole is not gonna break your fall. You're like, I'm gonna clench my asshole.
Dude, it's like nothing I do will save the fact if shit goes down, right? But
quite
as
literally.
As human beings, we can never, like 1 minute I'm, like, contemplating life, like, oh, fuck, man, what happens if the plane goes down? And the other minute, I'm like, oh, Fuck the plane, man. If it goes down, it goes down. Like,
I
dude,
like how you
I'm.
orgasm mid-flight, like,
Dude, I swear, man. Like, I think of it from like the first. I'm like, terrorist. Oh, fuck. The clinching begins, and I'm just like contemplating all my sins, man. I'm like, fuck, man. I should have worn a condom at that moment in time. Oh, fuck, man. Oh, fuck.
You mean you'll be having? There was a rumor at one point that you had a child already. I was like, what the fuck?
Dude, you guys be coming up with fucked
I
up
didn't
rumors,
come up
man.
with the rumor. It was
Who
Gushua.
the fuck?
It was Gushua that was like, apparently Kai got some chick pregnant. I was like, oh shit. That's why he ghosted on us for like a year and then just suddenly
I'm
popped
telling you,
up.
man, if I by mistake make a chick pregnant, I'm gonna be a man and then like fucking send him to China, man.
I really hate when like you know you're not pregnant but you keep saying, what if I'm pregnant? Like, fam, that does not change the fact that you're not pregnant or you are pregnant.
Dude,
That shit
like,
scares me. Like, I could not sleep. I'm like, what if she is pregnant? Like, I'm gonna be a dad and my parents are gonna be like this. And it's like, that shit is
dude,
scary.
know you probably thought of the ass whooping you would get.
It'll just be like, stupid boy, we sent you to Australia. You went and got a bitch pregnant. Like,
Oh,
I
shit.
am not ready for that. But my pull-out game is strong, you know?
But dude, this is the shit with going in raw, man. It's like, oh, okay, it's all good at that point. But dude, when the girls are, dude, I don't know why girls like warriors. The thing with girls is like, if they're close to you, right, they tell you
I like
everything
how
that's
we're
going
back
on
to
with them.
sex.
No, dude, it's like, okay, they don't get their periods for a few days. They're like, oh, I haven't been getting my period for a few days. They say it so nonchalantly. You're just saying that it hits you. It's like, oh, fuck. It's like, it was a good day. You're doing everything perfectly. She drops this shit. It's like, oh, I haven't been getting my period for a few days. And all of a sudden, your world closes in on you, man. You start like fucking.
You know what's
You
fucked
start
up?
like you start fatting your shirt, man. Wiping that fucking sweat that started coming down. Like, dude, one sentence can do so much, man. And then when she's like, oh, okay, I got my period today. Like, dude, it's like the fucking. You can see roses blooming, man. It's like you
You
start
know,
smiling and waving to
you
everybody like
know,
a
you
fucking
know what's
retard.
fucked up?
You
You know what's fucked up?
you go up an escalator, you start giving random high fives, and then there's one faggot who doesn't give you that high five, and you're just like, fuck this guy.
Okay, that sounds very personal. But you know what's fucked up when you actually tend to know more about her than she knows about herself, and then she's like, "How do you know this shit?" It's like, fam, if you paid attention in biology class, they made this explicitly clear. It's like, but yeah,
But
man.
dude, fuck this period sinking shit. It's like girls, right? If they're together for a long time, that shit starts synchronizing, man. So they be getting it all at the same time, and then you're there. Fuck, dude. It's like being thrown amidst sharks, man.
The thing with me is that I will never introduce my girl to my ex or a certain person who we both hate. Because
Oh,
that
fuck.
person is
Shout
like,
out to that person, man, with your mind games, man.
that person is like fucking poison, slow poison. She'll slowly eat it. Why are we gossiping about someone? Let's forget about that. So what
Fuck
next are
that
we
bitch,
talking about?
man. Fuck.
What next are we talking about?
I guess fuck, dude, like fuck all these like flights disappearing, whatever. They need to get their shit together, man, because I'm tired of clinching my asshole, man. Like, dude, I want to get through one flight where after it doesn't look like I've been fucking doing some sort of like yoga on my ass, man.
Okay, then this yoga in us, though. I don't
Dude,
know
I
what
don't
kind
even
of
know.
ass exercises you'd be taking pre-flight. Like, you'd
I
be
don't
like
know, man.
squeezing your left buttocks and your right buttocks before you
I
get
be
on the plane
training,
and
man.
shit.
I don't wanna strain out my ass, man.
Okay.
But dude, like, yeah, man, like, dude, hopefully this shit stops, man, because with all of this technology, they need to stop making this shit happen, man. Fuck.
Don't worry, nobody's gonna make a plane
And
full of trannies disappear.
side segues about this shit were like, dude, they're gonna come up with like a plane where it's like transparent throughout, so there's like
Oh
no
God.
like so the so like you
Why
can
is
see
you
everything.
laughing, Fafi?
So dude, you can see everything, man. Dude, so you see the cloud, you see the nearby planes. Dude, that's the last thing I want, man. You know
Why are
what's
you
gonna
laughing?
you,
Why are you laughing?
you know what's gonna end up happening, man? It's gonna end up with me, sweaty as fuck, closing my eyes and clenching my ass, man,
Oh
while
God,
holding.
please tell me you finally found a way to like air your smelly ass shoes and socks, man.
Nah, man, I started embracing the shit, man.
You have the most smelliest, I know that's not a word, but smelliest shoes and socks I've ever seen in my life.
Dude, it sounds like a word, man.
That shit be changing the aroma of the air of a room the moment you walk in. It's like, whoa. Like, what the fuck? Whoa.
Hey,
Like,
dude.
a
Hey,
breeze
dude.
just comes in with your stench and, like, whoa.
Dude,
You're a
that's how
sweaty
you
motherfucker, man. Your
leave.
palms be sweating for no reason. You just be holding it, and then you touch your hands, like, mad sweaty and shit.
Hey, dude, I have fast metabolism, man. You can't hold that against me.
And you were still fat at that point.
This fat card, though, fuck you. This is why I left a fucking dick imprint on your forehead, Anwar. Just remember this.
Just to remember that that part is going to get edited out.
Yeah,
Moving on.
let's go on to sports, man. Let's go on to sports, right?
Oh yes, and please, for the love of God, send me your audio on time.
Oh, fuck, dude. You need to stop being unprofessional, man.
Me being unprofessional.
Yes, you've been going out of character this whole time, you little
Coming
bitch.
from the guy who left me to go have a party. He was like,
Hey,
oh,
dude.
I go to have party. I'm like, bitch, we have something to do. We have to record this shit. It's like, oh no, this shit. I'm like, I can't be bothered. Because I knew you weren't gonna stay.
Hey, dude, when pussy calls, it calls, man. Like, you gotta do what
Can
fucks
you
with
hear
you.
this? And then this is the same person who'll be like, homies are for hoes. I don't like when guys betray their friends to go out with girls. You and Pedro are in the same boat, man.
Oh shit, stop comparing me to that maggot, man.
Yeah. Just know that all this part is getting edited out.
Yeah, surely, surely. All right, man, let's go on to football, to sports for now. Fuck, man, Mourinho went to Man United. Ah, fuck them, man. They're not in the Champions League anyway. Arsenal signed like a player called Granit Xhaka. He's hopefully gonna do good things for us, man.
I gave up on
And
Arsenal a long time ago.
fuck you, man. You're a bandwagon fan,
No,
man.
I'm not. If I was a bandwagon fan, I still wouldn't say I support Arsenal.
Nah, all right, no worries, man.
Unlike
But
you,
dude.
who bought a Leicester City kit, you fucking slut.
Dude, I shit you not. For this, like, I'm going back to town, right? Dude, their kits are like cheap as fuck, so I'm buying all the kits, man. I'm buying the home, the away, the I'm about to fuck some team kit. Dude, I'm buying all
Yeah,
the kits,
that
man.
Arabian money talking right now.
This Arabian money, though, dude. Dude, one thing, like, segue, one thing about saying people you're from Arabia or wherever the fuck they think I'm from, right? Dude, they think I have a fucking oil stop in my backyard, man.
I'm
It's
pretty
like,
sure you do.
oh. This bitch.
This guy's filthy rich, ladies and gentlemen. Ladies, hit up his DMs. He's got that deep pocket, you know what I'm saying?
This little bit. But yeah, dude, it's like you tell somebody from the Middle East, they're like, oh, you have an oil barrel in your backyard, yes? I'm
Why the
like,
fuck do they
dude.
have an Arab accent? Like, what the fuck?
But basically, they say that shit. I'm just like, fuck these guys, man. What oil barrel, man? I wish. But yeah, man. Yeah, and oh yeah, the Champions League is on the 29th, I think. Let me search this up.
Yeah, I think so. This unpreparedness, though, be searching
I
up
mean,
mid-podcast.
hey, dude, it's all organic.
You
It's
are
all
so
fine,
unprofessional, man. Calling me and didn't even have your shit set up.
man. But yeah. It's on the 29th. It's between Atletico and Real. Dude, I hope Atletico win, man. Because fuck Real, man.
No.
Fuck.
We need our boy Ronaldo to turn up.
Fuck your dick riding over Ronaldo, dude. You need to stop dick riding that guy, man. His neck, his
How
neck.
do
I shit you not.
I
I
dick
shit you not.
ride
His neck looks
Ronaldo?
like a veiny dick, man. It looks like a
I'm sure you
fucking
know what a
big.
veiny dick looks like when you take it up the ass so often, don't you? When
Okay,
you be
so I have
clinching
a
your
veiny dick
asshole.
too. But anyway, hey,
What,
dude.
did you just say
For
you
the.
have a great dick game?
What?
I swear that's what you said. You said, hey, I have a great dick
Dude, for the
game.
amount of times I've clipped my ass, I'm pretty sure no dick is gonna be able to enter this ass, man. Fuck. But anyway, dude,
That
like,
does not help. Okay.
fuck Ronaldo. I hope Atletico win. And yeah, in other news, like in basketball, they're having like the conference finals now. The
Steph Curry with
Toronto.
the wrist, boy.
This rap lyric though. But anyway, the Toronto have been hustling with the Cavaliers. It's all tied up, and the fucking.
I like what Charlemagne said that Drake needs to bring Party Next Door to the next game and have like a fucking taught what's the guy's name? Something Irvin? I don't
Kyrie
know.
Irving,
Kyrie
yeah.
Irving,
Oh
yeah.
God,
Something like I
bro.
fucked Kalani or something.
Dude, shit would be fucked up, dude.
That shit would actually like throw him off though.
Really, I don't think he's that pity. Dude,
Fuck, dude. It
a
would
guy who's
throw
on a
him off.
55 mil contract, dude, he should
Fam, you
fuck
literally just
bitches.
said like 5 minutes ago, pussy is everything. It would throw him off. And he'd, especially if she really loved that girl. If he really loved
If
that girl.
he really loved that girl, yeah. I don't know, man. But yeah, man, Kyrie lost the dick game to fucking Party Next Door, man.
Imagine how good that dick would have been for her to leave like 50 something, like a dude who's well, even though Party is like pretty decent with money, but
But
like
he's not on that 55 plus million per 4 years contract, man.
he finna get there. I think Party Next Door is the next big thing, man. OVO has like the talent, and they have that stimulus package in Drake that they're gonna take over R&B.
Yeah, Drake is pretty decent, man. The thing with Drake is like he has the pull on guys and he has the pull on girls too. It's like you hear
Drake.
girls talking about Drake too, not only guys, but like you go up to girls and like Kendrick Lamar, they're like, who the fuck is this dude?
But I think Drake is just a very smart person in the way he moves and the way he just sets his shit up. And he's very smart and he's very tactical with his stuff.
Yeah, that's very true. That's very true.
Let's see what Meek Mill has up in store. Dream Chasers 4 coming soon. I'm gonna listen to that shit, man.
I don't know, man. This shit needs to stop, man. Like Meek Mill needs to go on other like ventures because he's not gonna be able to hustle Drake anymore, man.
Nah, he can shoot his shot. Speaking of music, what do you think of The Weeknd's like leak mixtape?
Dude, I think it was all more. Yeah, it was like I didn't like it too much, to be honest. It was all like one track type of songs. Or what do you think?
I'm surprised you didn't like it, seeing as you're one of those people that say, "Oh, I like the old The Weeknd, you know, the
Dude,
fucking."
I dick ride, but I dick ride to a certain extent, man.
Yeah, by saying "Take Care" is better than "Nothing Was the Same," but I
Hey, dude,
digress.
that's my opinion, man. Come
Yeah,
on.
fuck to your opinion, man. Let's be objective here. If we're talking about sentimental value, yes, but as a from an objective standpoint, "Nothing Was the Same" is better. But yeah, with The Weeknd's mixtape, I think it was just like recordings he did for the albums. They were incomplete concepts, but I did like some of the concepts that were on there. They did sound very nice.
Yeah, that's very true. That's very
Very
true.
nice, very sexy.
I really like a few tracks on there.
So, should we wrap up? I think we're done.
I mean, oh yeah, one last thing, dude. Shout outs to Designer, man, with his release of Panda, the music video.
That came out like 3 weeks ago, fam.
I mean, yeah, 3 weeks ago, but like we didn't have one last week and I was really vibing to it. I thought it was over, but then Panda was back again. I was like, okay, here we go again with this shit.
I like the dude. He's very like energetic, and he has a certain charisma about him. And the song is dope. I'm looking forward to see what his album will be like. His album is gonna be called Life of Designer. It's gonna be dropping soon. It should be interesting.
But dude, Kanye, man, trying to hog all the spotlight, man. Like, if fucking, what's his name?
No,
What's the.
that's what Kanye always does, and that's what the Drake does as well. You
Yeah,
need
that's true.
he
That's true.
needs he
Yeah.
needs to be there so that like you know it's like you know he's like taking him under his wing, and he's like promoting him in a sense. That's what he did with like DaBunge. That's what he did with Kid Cudi. That's what he did with Travis Scott. Same thing Drake did with Party Next Door, with Majid
Yeah,
Jordan.
Macaron, yeah.
Yeah, they need to see them around there so that when they do drop, you know, it's a big thing. But I like Kanye, man.
I think Majid Jordan's gonna pop up soon, though. He's gonna pop up soon,
I
man.
feel like Majid Jordan, when they make the best songs, they give them to Drake. That's their
Yeah, but I
problem.
mean,
They
yeah,
need to
that's true,
hold
yeah.
they need to I think Drake understands what would pop off from their sound better than they do.
Obviously, yeah, obviously, yeah.
Because you look at My Love, you look at Hold On, We're Going Home, you look at what was the song on his
Like, dude,
album?
Hold On, We're Going Home. It was like a Majid song, and then he took it and then put Majid on the feature, was it?
What happened was that Nothing Was the Same. They were like figuring out, like they were camping out in the studio making Nothing Was the Same. So They had made the beat and like recorded some hooks and some things here and there, and they played it for 40, and 40 was like, yo, this is perfect. And then he played it for Drake, and then they were like, okay, we're gonna roll with this. And I think that's what happened with One Dance as well. Like, they were probably capping out in studio. Wizkid probably, made the beat and, put a few things here and there. And then Drake was like, you know what, let's pop on it, mastered the song and then made it. That's how Drake rolls. It's not like every song he sits down. No artist sits down and writes every single song down. Unless you're
Yeah, of
like in the
course.
very beginning. And even in the very beginning, you have someone or something that inspires you, or you have someone that like guides your creative process, like a producer or something.
Yeah, of course. But yeah, other than that, like, just shout out to designer fucking on the come up for $200 on that beat, man.
You know, the funny thing was that beat was made in the UK.
Oh shit.
So it was made by a British producer and then designer hopped on it. So it's really interesting to see.
Yeah, but I mean, just to know that he made that beat for like $200, damn dude, shit was fire, yo.
But he's still gonna get royalties. But yeah, man, that dude is 18 and we're still figuring out like how we gonna pop off, man. Inshallah, we pop off soon.
All right, man, we pop up soon, man, no worries.
All right, man. Thank you very much for listening. Thank you to all the
Yep.
people that listen. Thank you for the people that support us every week. Like, you have,
Hopefully they're here for the next week too,
yeah, you have no idea how much that means to us. Thank you for the people who share this with their friends, their families, that keep encouraging us to keep this going forward. And
yeah.
yeah,
Have we had our first comment yet?
no, not yet.
It's probably gonna be some shit talk, man. It's like these
Something like you
faggots,
guys are faggots or you guys are no
man.
shit or something like that. But
Probably, yeah.
all love, man, all love. So
All love, yeah.
thank you for listening. My name is Dujarja Prime. See you next week.
Yep, and this is Kai Ash. Hopefully, we see you guys next week. And peace out.